Hey everybody, Dr. Cranky back. It's Saturday. We are continuing on. We've decided, we were illuminated, and we've decided to go ahead and paint the chassis black, but have it with some of the rust and some of that old green to signify perhaps that it has been repainted several times, etc., etc. So we are going to do that. We've got our paint here, and then a little bit of gray too, just in case we want to come back in and do some of that. Then after that, I'm going to show you, for those of us who every once in a while get tempted to use the craft acrylics, how I sort of mix mine and get it ready for the airbrush, blah, blah, blah. But that'll be coming up in the next episode, or, you know, in the next video. We've have all the parts and primer. We've got the interior, which we are also going to hit up with a little bit of black and that gray. This has been primered. It's ready to go. So, you know, we are going to set up our airbrush, right? Sometimes when we have the airbrush out, we hit it up with a little bit of glass cleaner, right? Just a little bit, and run it through. I use the Publix brand of generic glass cleaner, and that's good enough. I've realized that you can in fact hear me over the sound of the airbrush. The compressor. So here we are. We are running the, you can see it there. Well, maybe you can't. I don't know if you can. If it gets glossy, right? I'm spraying through that glass cleaner just to get everything going. And then, as I said, we've already salted the frame there, and we're just going to come in with a little bit of black, which is a kind of a dark gray. It's not necessarily black. There you see it going on, right? So the airbrush is working perfectly, and sometimes we just leave it like this and kind of hit it in spots, right? We want to cover some of it but not all of it, right? That way some of the green and the rust will show through, right? But this is a nice way of darkening any kind of chassis like this. Just gives it a little bit more interest. And I knew it was going to be dark. I've really never liked any kind of a light chassis. So now here we're just going to hit up around the edges again, making sure that we leave a little bit of the color showing through, right? This is part of the fun of using the airbrush. You can kind of localize where you're putting the paint, and that's part of the fun, right? You can stipple, which is kind of a little art form, just to get the sometimes if you crimp the if you crimp the hose, you can, that's why sometimes you see me holding the hose like that, just to get a little bit of spatter here and there, well-placed spatter, and a little spatter in all the right places. So the underside, nobody's gonna see, so you don't have to sweat it, but I do want there to be a variety from underneath so people can see the airbrush is still, sometimes I loosen up the there you go, until it starts again. So this is quite a blast, and you'll see it come through Once I wash it again, there'll be some green and rusty spots coming through because we've salted the heck out of the frame in places, so we're not really worried. Right, we just want to make sure that we're getting a good, there you go, it's changed radically, and there it is. I mean, you could continue if you feel like you need a little bit more. Yeah, it's still spraying. Every once in a while, I think it's not spraying anymore, but it is. Now, the other thing is, I normally will use a hair dryer to get it dried up faster. But you can let it air dry. It doesn't really matter that much. Now with the leftover paint, we are going to come in and basically do the bottom, fog in the bottom of the interior just to get it. And there you see the beauty of it, right? It stipples and it just creates a nice, and again, the interior, the inside of the tub, nobody's gonna see. So we're not really worried about it. We're just doing a little bit of spraying with the black all around. I mean, you can go ahead and give it variety if you want. Also, on the interior, you can shade a little bit, right? It never hurts. A little dirt around the corners, that's all right. That's why we have the other gray on here, because we can add it and come back and, you know, do what you need to do so that it all looks good. So that's pretty much for it right now. So we'll come back and show you some more in a moment. All right, my friends, stay tuned in.